Okay, so we're going to come around and sit back up on your heels. I'm going to be working with your light weights today. So I've got some 1 kilo weights ahead. As always, use them or don't use them. Just see how you're feeling as you work through your practice. So I'm going to reach all the way up towards the top end of your mat. And then as we gently start to pull the body along the ground, staying low to the floor. And as we lift up, bring the shoulders back. And as we come up into your cat stretch, let's round up through your shoulders and your back. And then taking your head and your tailbone away, and let's sit yourself back down upon your heels. And again, let's bring the body to pull on up, rolling down the shoulders and lifting the chin. Let's go up into cat again, pulling up through shoulders, up into your back. Taking the head and the tailbone away and sitting back down upon your heels. Again, let's bring the body to pull on up. And now curling with your toes, sending the hips up towards the ceiling and the head down through your arms. Bring the body forwards into a high plank and bending with your knees and gently release and sit back to your heels. Bring the body to pull on up and along the ground, lifting the chin. Curling with your toes, push off into a nice long downward facing dog. Draw forwards into a high plank, then bending with your knees, and gently releasing and sitting it back. Again, let's draw the body to pull on up, open up with the collarbone. Curling with your toes, sending the hips back and the head down through your arms. And draw forwards into a strong high plank, bending your knees and gently releasing and sitting it back. And again, let's bring the body up, working into that release of your lower back. As you curl the toes, feel the release of the muscles and stretching them out along the back of your legs. Come forwards to high plank, engaging with your core, then bending with your knees and sitting it all the way back. Let's have a couple more if you can, drawing the body up. And then curling with your toes and sending the hips back. And draw forwards into a high plank, bending your knees and sitting it all the way back. One more time, bring the body to pull on up. This time, as we go to a downward dog, stay in and walking your feet from one to the other, spreading your fingers nice and wide to the ground, and just working those hips a little from one side to the other, treading it down, noticing your lower back, checking in with it, noticing the legs and the power you have in your arms today. And just always feel free just to take a little bit of a break if you need to. Now if we can come back down upon your knees and placing your right foot forwards. And let's just take down your right hand to the side of your right foot. Bringing your left arm to reach up and over, looking upwards towards your hand.
Draw your toes back. Again, let's stretch the toes towards the
breath in, and as you breathe out, let's stretch over, out into the side body. Breathing in as we come back up, and again, breathing out, just taking that stretch across into side body. Breathing in to bring it back up. Breathing out, letting your arms all the way back down. Stepping your left foot forwards. Just taking down your left hand to the side of your left foot. Bring your right arm to reach up and over. Look up towards your hand. Bring your hand back on down. Push it to the floor. Lift the back knee. Raising your left arm. Nice good stretch into that back leg. Try and keep it nice and straight. Bring knee back down upon the ground. Let's raise back up through for your upper body. Left hand going back behind the right this time. Letting your arms down. Let's move back upon that back knee. Dig in the heel in, toes drawing back, extend through tailbone, press from the center of your chest. And let's push down through your toes. And then drawing your toes back and back. Again, press away through your toes. And then gently draw the toes back. And again, pressing away through your toes. Back. One more time, press down through the toes and then gently draw the toes back and then round up through your back and let's bring ourselves around onto our backs. So just having your hand weights close by so that we're able to work with them quite quickly. Coming down onto your back and let's just set up the body here. So firstly, just working a little bit of a rock of your lower back, forwards and backwards. Notice your imprint. Notice how that feels for you today. And then settle into neutral. Bring the shoulders to roll up and down a few times. And just notice how they are for you today. And then working them down, taking them a little further down and away from your ears. Wriggle the neck out a little, give some space to the neck and the upper part of your body, so around the collarbone. Let's take a deep breath in through your nose, bring the ribs to widen laterally. And then as you breathe out of your mouth, let's pull up on the pelvic floor, draw up through to your transverse abdominis muscle. As you breathe in, let's let the ribs widen, the belly remains flat. And then as you breathe out, let's engage the core, pulling up and behind the surface muscles. A couple more times, let's take that deeper breath in. Feel that new oxygen coming up to the brain, around the body system. One more time, take that deep breath in. Blow the breath out like you're blowing down a straw. And then let's bring the hands to sit back behind your head, letting your elbows fall back to the earth. Coming into your out breath. Let's breathe in through your nose, not the chin. As you breathe out of your mouth, let's raise the upper body and engage the core. Breathing in to stay, and then breathing out, engaging the core as you lower back down to the floor. Breathing in, let's not the chin. As you breathe out, right hand. Okay, and then from here, we're going to be lifting and lowering the left leg. So let's take the weight back. And then as we lift the leg, breathing out and breathing in as we lower. Breathing out to lift and breathing in to lower. Now alternatively, you could support your head, okay, with your right hand. If you can leave your leg up there and it will stay. All right, if you're okay holding the leg, it's feather hold, so it's not too hard. And this one, we're coming straight up and straight down. It's not a cross. So the left leg's going down, the left arm's going back, and then they're coming up together. Breathing in as we go down, breathing out to go down, breathing in to come up. Out as we go away from the body, in as we come back up. Breathing out, engage the core, in to come back up. One more time, and in to come back up. And come on down, we'll swap sides. So let's take the left leg up, and then again, you can either support it or put your hand behind the head if your leg will stay there. Then raising your arm, and as you lift the leg up, you can draw your weight up towards your leg, and then take it all the way back. Breathing out to draw up, and breathing in as we draw back. Like I said, you could keep the leg up there, you could bend your knee, okay? So don't feel that you have to keep that leg straight. So breathing in, and breathing out as we go back, breathing out to go back, breathing in to come up on this one. We've got to really support that extension, and up, breathing out to go away with both arm and leg, breathe in to come back up. Breathing out and in, last one. And let's come on all the way back. Okay, place your weight down. And let's gently make our way around onto your elbows and knees. Now, we're going to work us up into dolphin. Okay, we're going to work dolphin, then we're going to be coming up onto our hands for some glute work. Dolphin, we want the elbows, we want to be able to reach for the elbows and then make that V shape with our hands and we're clasping the fingers together. So come on down, wrap your hands around the elbows, check you've got a good position, clasp your fingers. We can start on the knees here. So as we come forwards, breathing out, as we draw back, breathing in. Breathing out and engaging with the core as you come forwards. Breathing in to push back. And if that's hard enough, stay as. If you think you could curl the toes and lift out through the hips, then coming forwards, breathing out and breathing in to send your hips back. Breathing out as you come forwards and breathing in, sending your hips back. Breathing out, engage the core, coming forwards. Breathing in, send the hips back. Navel back to the spine, weight bearing into your forearms. Breathing in, coming back. Really pull up through the belly as you come forwards. And breathing in to draw back. Breathing out, engage as you come forwards. Breathing in to draw back. Let's have two more there. Breathing out forwards and breathing in, pull back. One more time and breathing in to draw back. And then lower yourself down upon your knees. Okay, so I'm planting my hands beneath the shoulders. If you have any problems being up onto your hands, by all means go down upon your elbows again. Now what you'll find, you won't be able to do the arm work. Okay, but you may be more comfortable, so it might be the better option. So I'm going to use one hand weight again. I'm going to take it out and away from the body. I'm going to be raising the arm away from the body. So you could, of course, do this without a weight. So if you'd like to take the opposite leg to the arm that you've got the weight for, I'm going to lift the leg up and lower it down. And at the same point, lift up your arm and lower it down. So you can do this with a weight. You can do this with just your arm. You can keep both hands on the floor. Or or you can put your elbows on the ground. So we're breathing out to lift, breathing in to lower. So try and keep a neutral back. Try not to sink into your lower back. Pull up through the belly as you press into lower. Breathing out to lift, into lower. Nice straight leg behind you. Breathe out, lift and lower. Again, breathing out to lift and lower. Belly pulls in as you lift and lower. Nice long neck. So try not to look beneath you. Two more on that side. Breathe out, lift and lower. One more. And relax. Okay, let's work it to the other side. So setting the body up, take the leg out behind you. Shoulders drawn back, bottom rib pulled up. Breathe out to lift the leg and the arm. And breathe in to lower. Breathing out as you lift. And into lower. Nice strong straight leg. Lift and lower. Again, breathing out to press. Breathing into lower. Nice strong engagement through your core. Into lower. Point the toes on the leg behind you. And lower. Breathing out to lift. And into lower. Again, engaging with the core as you lift. And lower, breathing out to press, and lower, good, last one, and relax. Okay, now come around to a seated position. And we're going to work into rolling back. So just bring yourself to sit up nice and tall. You could be using a band around your feet, or you could be using something behind your back, a little cushion, to provide a little bit of extra support. I will work with the weights again in just a moment. We're just going to work down to begin with, get set ourselves up. Deep breath in, let the ribs widen. And then as you breathe out, let's pull back through your belly, curve your lumbar spine. Stop out at halfway, breathe in. And then breathing out to slowly bring your body up. Nice tall seated position. Again, deep breath in, ribs widen. As you breathe out, sinking down through to your lumbar spine, breathe in and breathing out as you come. You decide how far back you're going to go. So if you would like to use again more weight, we're taking it out in front of us. I'm holding the ends. Shoulders nice and relaxed. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, slowly rolling yourself back. Breathe in. Breathing out, gently bring it up, as if you're offering it to somebody else. Deep breath in, breathing out, slowly working your body back. Breathing in, breathing out, to slowly draw your body back on up. Good, deep breath in, breathing out, navel back to the spine as you go back. Breathing in, and breathing out, to slowly draw your body back on up. Breathe in, breathing out, engage your core, working it back. Breathing in, breathing out, engaging the core, trying not to jerk the body forwards. Deep breath in, making it nice and smooth, lowering your body back. Breathing in, breathing out as we slowly come back up. Good. Couple more. Breathe in and out, lowering your body back. Breathe in and out and slowly come back up. And the last one's going to take you down. You're going to stay down. So deep breath in, breathing out, lowering your body back and remaining. Okay. So I'm going to go for your heel dig next. And I'm going to offer up that we use both arms. Working into a little of a chest opener on this one. So my hands are going to go above my chest. I've got my feet up, I'm going to flex out with my feet. As I take one heel down to the floor, I'm going to open the chest and let the arms come straight to the side of the body and then come back on up on an in-breath. Breathing out to lower the heel down. Breathing in to draw way, all right? Make it so that you can concentrate on what you're doing, okay? So at the end of the day, it's great to add in pieces of equipment, but if we do it and we find that, again, all of a sudden we're not doing our technique properly, and just take it back a little. Breathing out, engaging the core, take the heel down, breathing in. Again, breathing out, navel back to the spine, and breathing in. Again, breathing out, take the heel, breathing in. Two more, breathing out, and in. One more, and in. Okay, land the feet, and place your hands down to the floor, my waist down. I'm going to work 100 in here. Okay, so if you're using something behind your head, pop that into position, bringing your legs up, but this time extending them maybe, or pointing your toes. Bring your head and shoulders up, and let the elbows come nice and wide. If you're giving your a little bit of a pat by the side, you don't need to support your head, pop your hands down, and let's set up a breathing pattern. So you're breathing in for about four, and then breathing out for about six. Maybe shut your eyes, go inside. See that you're squeezing and pulling in every time you breathe out. So visualize the muscles strengthening through the midline, that third layer of abdominal muscle in. We're going with 25, 26, 7, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 3, breathing out, and as you lower it back down, breathe. Breathing out as you lift and into lower. Again, let's breathe out, extend the leg away and in as you lower. Couple more, breathing out to lift and lower. Okay, now the next one is much smaller. So on the next one, I'd like us to take the toe to come forwards and then the heel to go back behind the other heel. Again, we're going to keep that leg straight, breathing in, come forwards, breathing out, roll the leg back. Breathing in forwards with the toe, engage the core as you go back. And again, breathing in forwards, breathing out, heel goes back. Breathing in, turn the toe forwards, breathing out, flex the heel on the way back. Breathing in, draw the toes back on the way back. Feel that stretch coming through your ankle, working through the ankle and the foot. Breathing in forwards, breathing out as you go back. Let's have two more there. Breathing out to go back. One more. And out to come back. And then if we just take a hold of that top leg, draw back into a quad stretch.
Turn your knee downwards and back. Lock
into the core, so that you want to minimize as much movement as you can from the hips. So it really is moving around those intricate muscles around the top of your leg. Breathing out, engage to go back. Breathing in. That way then we're going to really improve your range of motion, your strength into these intricate muscles. And again, breathe in forwards, out as you go back. Breathing in, blow the breath out on the way back. Two more, breathe in, breathing out and back. One more, and back. And then bending up that top leg again. Let's take it off into a little quad stretch. Breathing in to stay, and then breathing out as you
shoulders roll back and down, breathing out to engage with your core as you lift, breathing in, and then breathing out as you lower all of the way back down. And just let your weights down, and just coming up onto your forearms, have your elbows now a little bit wider than your shoulders. Going to come up into the Sphinx. Let your legs be a little bit wider behind you. And take a little breath in. As you breathe out, just gently raise your upper body, looking forwards. And then breathing in as you lower it back down. Breathing out, engaging your core, lifting up onto your forearms. And breathing in as you lower back down. Breathing out as we lift. Breathing in as we lower, keeping the chest open, the shoulders down and away from your ears, and breathing in as you lower, breathing out as we flex the back, working the curve of the lumbar spine, breathing in as you lower it back down, okay, breathing out as we lift.
Breathing in to draw back. Again, breathing out as we turn. Breathing in to
back onto your back again. Last couple of positions are meant to be on your back. So lowering yourself back and down. Now I'm going to work a version of the double leg extension. Option here to use a weight. Okay, I'm going to be holding it this time in both hands like a microphone. Soles of the feet are coming together. And I'll get going with the legs first of all. So we breathe out to push the feet away, sit them side by side. As you come down, the feet are flat at each other, the knees are wide. Breathing out, work through the ankles, work through the feet, breathing in. Now with this one, if you would like to add on, breathing out, taking the weight back behind you, and then breathing in to draw back on down. Breathing out, taking that weight to go back behind you, breathing in as you draw back down. As you go back, keep the shoulders down, try not to let your shoulders lift too much. Breathing in. Now the aim here is not to touch the floor, you're not going that far back. You just want to go as far as you can with strength. So if you are a little bit stronger, you have the option to go further away from the body, but make it equal. So make the arms going away be equal to the legs going away. Just be very careful that your back doesn't lift off the ground. You want a neutral spine, and you want to hold that by using your core. Otherwise, if you just end up letting your back arch, you're going to feel a bit sore around the back probably tomorrow. So just be careful when you go back, if it gets too much, you put that weight down, you don't have to use the weight. And in. Again, breathing out to press away. And breathing in to draw in. Two more. Breathing out, pressing back. Breathing in. One more. Breathing out to press back. Placing your weight down. Okay, my last position, my last offering for you today is going to be reverse curl work. You could, for this position, or these last two positions, use a block beneath your back or a book or a cushion just to help you lift a little, reverse curling. If it doesn't agree with you at all, come back and do a few more of the heel digs. Because both of these exercises work the abdominals lower to upwards, they will both do a similar job. So for the baby reverse curl, we've got the knees bent, we're going to take the hands up and above you. And as we work the lower back upon the floor, breathing out. And then as you release back and away, breathing in. Breathing out, engaging the core, send the lower back to hold onto the floor. And then breathing in to release. But we don't want to swing the legs, you know, we really want to get a hold of being able to control and release. Now for those of you who feel like you'd like to work into your rollover, place your hands along the ground, take a breath in, and as you breathe out, very slowly letting your back peel away from the floor. It's a big back stretch, alright, so don't feel you've got to push into it. Breathing in, breathing out, and then we slowly lower. Okay, but like I say, so maybe having something beneath your tailbone will help you up a little. So we're breathing out to very slowly send the legs upwards, breathing into separate legs, and then breathing out to slowly come back down with the legs about hip distance apart. We bring them together at the end. Again, breathing in, breathing out to slowly send the legs up. Try not to push too hard with your hands. Breathing in at the back, breathing out. Certainly you don't want to make your triceps do all of the work. And also your triceps have done quite a lot already. Deep breath in, breathing out. As we send the legs over, try and make the abdominals do the job. Breathing in to separate the legs. Breathing out to slowly roll it back. Last one coming up, breathe in, breathing out slowly, sending the legs up, breathing in to separate the legs, and then breathing out to slowly roll your way all the way back on down. Bring the legs in together, and everybody, when you're ready, drop them down towards the floor. Now straightening out your left leg, bring your right knee in towards you, and then take your left hand across towards your right knee, gently draw it over, take your right hand out to the side, and then maybe lift your head up and see if you can get your ear quite firmly against the floor. Bring it back. Okay, making your way back up to seated. Now bring yourself around to a seated position of your choice. Going to work into a little reverse turn. Palm facing open, back of the hand going to the front of your knee. Sit yourself up tall and look up over your shoulder. To the middle.